Okay, we made it to the hotel. Get my bags. Well, the show has officially opened here in Chicago. This is Roosevelt with Auto Network. I'm here at the Chicago Auto Show, first day of Media Day. And this is the Concept and Technology Hall. Here we have a Mustang convertible. As you can see, people are doing interviews. And I'll just walk through the line. You can take a look. Let me know in the comment section what you think. Anything you see you like. Anything you see you may not. Some of the products that's just being interviewed. But I'm just gonna do a quick walkthrough. This won't be a long video. You can take a look around.
The thing is, it's been
cheap. Introducing everybody, raving about. And this Toyota truck right there is owned, that's the personal truck for somebody. Road. That's a Cadillac because everybody's crawling up to Escalade IQ. Like I said, this will be just a quick pass through with technology and concept.
Front, the lower intake area has active air flaps. They're designed to automatically open and close the air intake opening according to driving conditions. Carnival Turbo Hybrid also features E-Ride, which can improve ride comfort by alleviating up and down shocks when passing over bumps by automatically adjusting shock damping.
As we make our way to the side, you'll notice these wheels and tires here, and they're very significant because there are 21-inch wheel on the Elite with 275-foot tires. So these are the largest wheel and tires we've ever put on a production Honda vehicle. Despite that, the vehicle still gets really good driving range and ride comfort. Now, for mobility and electrified strategy moving forward, Moto Compacto is already on sale. It's a $995 MSRP, so very affordable, but also very portable. And as Jake is doing very quickly, you can see you can fold it up into essentially a large briefcase. There's actually a handle built in. You can take it with you. It's roughly 40 pounds, so it's not too heavy. Around our diamond pentagon grille, we have an illumination that lights up with the headlights. So it looks very premium at night and gives ZDX a kind of signature look and feel, being our first electric SUV. For a long time, you can get EVgo public charging credits. Now, no matter which package you ultimately choose from, all of them include some level of public charging credit.
The sound bar is wrapped and it spans the whole dashboard. And it's meant to look like the inside of your living room, to be comfortable, to be a space that you want to spend time in.
And then additionally, we do also have the F-150 Lightning Platinum Black over here in the corner. My coworker will be around that one to help answer questions with that. And
whatever learnings we get out of that obviously then comes out and goes into all of these great products that you see here. So that's really the goal of the program.
Now, as we look towards the next 75 years and effectively what will be our electric future, we have a whole new generation of drivers to inspire.
This is the pole-to-pole Aria. There was a presentation yesterday at the breakfast with the couple that drove this literally from pole to pole. This is an all-electric vehicle, the Nissan Aria.
At the mid $50,000 range.
It will be available in three different trim levels: the 1958 model, which is the one that's sharing the stage with me here, the Land Cruiser.
But having said that, we do update certain hardware updates to model years. So with 2024, we listen to our customers, we listen to our retail and studio.
AutoNetwork. Please like, subscribe, comment. As always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive. Buckle up, don't text and drive. See you next time.